Another tool we have in our CSS layout toolbox that a lot of folks don't know about are viewport units. Viewport units are a way to size things based on the space that's available and the size of the viewport itself. The viewport is either the edges of the browser window, especially on maybe a desktop machine, or how big the glass is, especially perhaps on a mobile screen, phone, or tablet, or sometimes Windows, people have things full screen. Anytime somebody has a browser window full screen, then the viewport size is the size of the glass itself. Viewport units have been talked about when it comes to sizing type. Folks have been thinking about and writing about ideas to make the type smaller or bigger, depending on how much space is available. But you can also size objects on the page, boxes or graphics or photos, based on the size of the viewport itself. You can see here in this example, I've created this header so that the header is 100 viewport units high. VH stands for viewport height. And no matter how big the window is when the page loads, that header covers the whole space. And the moment the user scrolls, the article is right there visible to the user, to the reader, so they're not confused about where it is. Basically, any place that you might use an M, a rem, a percent, a pixel, instead you could use a VH unit, a viewport height number, a VW unit, Vmin or Vmax. Vmin will look at the two dimensions and pick the smaller of the two, and Vmax will look at the two dimensions and pick the larger of the two. Here are two examples. It's really one example in two different web pages with two different viewport sizes or aspect ratios, and you can see as I scroll how the layout responds to the viewport that's available. This might especially be handy when you're doing something like an application layout or some sort of a toolbar that you want to change the shape and the size and the layout of the buttons based on the space that's available. So how does that happen? It happens because I'm actually, in this drawing you could see I am sizing that blue box with a height and a width of a viewport of 50 VH and 50 VW. I could also then either place it on a grid using CSS grid, or I could use margins in order to place it so that there's 25 VH above and below the box and 50 VH to the left of the box. By using viewport units to place things, you can either set the sizes and or set the space. You know, maybe you have a big long article and there's a data visualization in the middle of the article. It might be really nice so that as people scroll, when they get to the data visualization, it's not too big for the space that's there, or it's not too small, but it kind of fills up the space and, you know, makes it as big as possible, but lets people still see the whole thing all at once, like a map or something. Here you can see a diagram where I got that circle to always be that size by sizing it as 50 Vmin. So it's always 50% of the shorter dimension, whether it's height or width. Viewport units are pretty amazing. You can do all kinds of interesting things with them. As we develop skills in our new system for layout, it's one of the things that we really consider. You know, before the responsive web design came along, we really focused on fixed width websites, whether they were 960 or whatever the size was, and we really kind of imagined that we knew where the top was and we knew where the left edge of the page was. We didn't really control anything else. We sort of pretended that the other edge, the right edge, was always in a good place, but really we had no control. We sort of thought a lot about those two edges. Then when responsive design came along, we thought a lot about both sides of the page and how you might squish or make something wide based on those two sides of the page. But all along we've said, there is no fold, there is no bottom edge. We can't control the fold. We can't control whether something is above or below that edge, whether or not people see it right away or they don't see it. It's true that we haven't had ways to control what goes above or below the edge of where scrolling starts. But it's not true that that fourth edge doesn't exist. And now that we have viewport units, there's a lot of things that we can start to do to control the fourth edge and to think about what may or may not be in the viewport as a user loads the page or as they scroll down the page. And I think that thinking about our viewport and using viewport units to size things is a big part of what web design is going to become. I think it's a big part of starting to truly design for the medium that we have. So check out viewport units, think about how you might use them today in very simple ways, and how you might use them in the future in much more complicated ways.